Pyramidal system. Pyramidal system is the main voluntary motor pathway. It consists of two neurons, upper motor neuron and lower motor neuron. The upper motor neuron lies in the cerebral cortex. The lower motor neurons are motor nuclei of the cranial nerves and motor neurons present in the anterior horn cells of the spinal cord. Pyramidal tract. Pyramidal tract or corticospinal tract. The fibers of the corticospinal tract arise from the pyramidal cells lying in the motor area of the cerebral cortex. So majority of the corticospinal tract fibers arise from the primary motor area. Okay. It also receives fibers from the associated motor area and also from the sensory areas. So the fibers of the corticospinal tract arises from the pyramidal cells lying in the motor area of the cerebral cortex. These fibers converge, okay, and descends through the corona radiata, posterior limb of internal capsule, 3/5 of the crest cerebrae of the midbrain, 3/5 of the crest cerebrae of the midbrain, and basilar part of the pons. In the pons, the fibers are divided into many small longitudinal bundles by pontine nuclei and cerebellopontine fibers. In the medulla oblongata, the fibers runs in the or descends in the pyramid of the medulla, hence the name pyramidal tract. In the lower part of the medulla, majority of the fibers crosses to the opposite side. So crossing over takes place in the lower part of the medulla and it is known as pyramidal decussation. The fibers which have crossed to the opposite side descend and enters into the lateral white column of the spinal cord and continues as lateral corticospinal tract. So majority of the fibers cross to the opposite side and enters the lateral white column of the spinal cord and continues as lateral corticospinal tract. The uncrossed fibers descends on the same side and enters the anterior white column and continues as ventral corticospinal tract. The lateral corticospinal tract lies between, that is, lies in front of the posterior grey horn and median to the posterior spinocerebellar tract. So that is the exact situation of the corticospinal tract in the lateral white column. The ventral corticospinal tract lies in the ventral white column near the anterior median fissure. Near the anterior median fissure. the lateral corticospinal tract and the ventral corticospinal tract fibers finally terminate by synapsing into the anterior horn cells present in the ventral gray matter of the spinal cord. So this is the origin, course and termination of the corticospinal tract. It is a motor pathway. Upper motor neuron lesion or lesions of the corticospinal tract. The lesion of the corticospinal tract or upper motor neuron lesions results in hemiplegia with or without the involvement of cranial nerves. The clinical features or signs of the upper motor neuron lesions are: number one, spastic paralysis. That is, when the upper motor neurons are damaged, it loses its control over the lower motor neuron. So consequently, this results in hyperactive of lower motor neurons. So this causes hypertonia, that is increased muscle tone, spasticity of the muscles, that is abnormal muscle tightness due to prolonged muscle contraction, and exaggerated tendon reflex, that is knee elbow reflex, or that is biceps tendon reflex and knee reflex are exaggerated. Babinski's sign is present when the lateral part of the sole of the foot is scratched with a blunt instrument. Usually the toes will flex, plantar flex. The great toe is dorsiflexed and the lateral toes fan outside. That is the Babinski sign. So in upper motor neuron lesions, the Babinski sign is present. Superficial abdominal reflex is absent in upper motor neuron lesions. When the skin over the anterior abdominal wall is scratched, the superficial abdominal muscle will contract, but in upper motor neuron lesions, it is absent. Cremastic reflex is also absent. When the skin over the medial side of the thigh is stroked, cremastic reflex takes place, but in upper motor neuron lesions, it is absent. Loss of performance of fine skill movements are absent in upper motor neuron lesions. Muscle proneness is present, that is uncontrolled rhythmic movement is present in upper motor neuron lesions. So what is the difference between upper motor neuron lesion and lower motor neuron lesion? In upper motor neurons lesion, the neurons present in the cerebral cortex is mainly damaged. In lower motor neurons, the anterior horn cells present in the gray matter of the spinal cord is damaged, or the motor nucleus of the cranial nerves is damaged. In upper motor neurons, you have hypertonia, increased muscle tone. In lower motor neurons, you have hypotonia. Spasticity of muscles is present in upper motor neurons, whereas in lower motor neurons, flaccidity of the muscles can be seen. Exaggerated tendon reflex is present in upper motor neuron lesions. The tendon reflex is weak or absent in lower motor neurons. Muscle proneness is present in upper motor neuron lesion. It is absent in lower motor neuron lesions.